At first, when I was thinking about this, I thought, well, it'd be easier to say what hasn't changed.
Many transformations in all the years I've been here, needless to say.
You name a space, it has changed since I've been here.
For instance, the room we're sitting in as we record this was like the room I lived in for 1 year.
The room we sit in was the Serial's work room. This was my domain. This was the periodicals reading room.
And so that was where we did business. It's kind of like right about right here.
And now here we are sitting in this crazy modern technology space that we wouldn't have dreamed of when we were sitting there in the 1980s.
Well, in the 1970s, the Cat catalog still occupied most of the space in the reference room.
The center of the whole library was the card catalog.
They took up a huge amount of space.
When you looked into that, those doors in the lobby, it's just card catalog.
It was like, you know, the monolith in 2001. It just stood out in my mind as this remarkable achievement.
You know, it was a real reference room, full of card catalogs and books.
It was just, you know, the tender love and care that went into putting that together.
Well, when you think of the person hours that went into that entity, it's just amazing.
The reference room underwent huge renovation in 1994. We moved the card catalog down to the former smoking lounge.
We were not allowed to have any food or drink in the building except for in the staff lounge, but we were allowed to smoke. In fact, smoking in the lounges was one of the ways you were supposed to meet people as a student. So when I was a freshman, I actually learned to smoke in the level A lounge, hoping to, you know, meet some guys.
Then the whole concept of bringing in a coffee shop.
There was no cafe in the lobby back then. No food or drink was allowed in the stacks.
You know, if you tried to bring in water or coffee or anything, it was taken from you.
Since I came here, the cafe is new. We never had anything like that.
Adding the cafe and opening up the fin room, creating the fin room is amazing. I love the fin room. That's my favorite room.
The tail end of the reference collection is now the fin room, this beautiful room for where people can study, and there's it, well before the fin room, it was also the Hacker Center, another thing we would not have imagined when we were filing books away and in the reference collection that was in that room when I first came here in the 80s.
The classroom space that we have now, Hecker and DSL, didn't exist.
And of course, now there's the DSL, which is yet another room that has changed since I've been at The Rock.
Spaces have changed remarkably. What's been nice is since we haven't had a major renovation in several years, there's been lots of mini renovations that, to me, having been here a long time, are quite remarkable.
Needless to say, it's wonderful to see this change. It's remarkable. It's so changed. The work has changed so much with, you know, computers, digitization, and it's constantly changing and it's the last few years have been in just an incredible change.
So I was at The Rock through quite a transition. The library changed quite a bit and became, you know, much more modern.